To get started, all you need are some Inktense pencils and blocks, paint brushes, textile medium or fabric fixative, which helps prevent the colours from bleeding into each other too much, a pencil, and some water cups and a rag or two. To start us off, I've prepared the surface by taping a piece of approximately 9 by 11 inch white cotton fabric onto a firm waterproof surface. Then I've lightly sketched the approximate shape of the petals for the flower. Begin by applying dry Inktense onto the fabric, building up and blending, toning colours. Then, using a mix of approximately half and half water to fabric fixative, begin brushing the Inktense into the fabric. As you progress, add more Inktense until you achieve the balance, tone, and intensity that pleases you. Before adding the final touches to the flower, you need to apply some colour to the background, using the side of the blocks to create broad sweeps of colour, and then brush them into the fabric. Once the background is finished, use your pencils to add highlights to the flower. Add as much or as little as you like, depending on whether you plan to quilt the piece later on. Thank you. Here's a piece showing how quilting can bring out elements of the design. And this small quilt was made from two similar flower panels and a piece of hand-dyed blue background fabric.